Hello, everyone. Happy Sunday. Hope you're having a good weekend so far. Let's just get into it. A friend of mine alerted me to the story just a while ago this morning. There have been several media reporting that there's been an explosion and a large fire at an oil refinery plant in West Virginia. This was, I'm not sure how you pronounce the name of this town. It's Ergon, Ergon, West Virginia. It's apparently in the northern part of the state. But this was overnight. There was an explosion and a large blaze that was finally put under control. It looks like it said there were dozens of fire crews involved in this. The fire was apparently brought under control overnight. No injuries or deaths reported, so that's good. Don't know the extent of the damage or the disruption. I did watch a couple of videos from news sources a while ago, there were videos from nearby residents or people that were apparently watching it, and it did look like a pretty large fire. But there's no news, at least so far, about the extent of the damage, like I said, or where or if it's going to cause a disruption in their oil refinery process. I would imagine it would have some kind of impact. By the size of that fire, the way it looked on video. So just wanted to get this out there to y'all. Something to keep an eye on and see if we can learn any more news as the day goes on or as the weekend progresses here. These things seem to happen on the weekends. And now it's a holiday weekend, right? So we all know what usually happens after something like this. Gas prices go up, you know, any excuse to jack it up on us again, right? I mean, we're already paying, what, $1 more a gallon now than we were a year ago? More than that in some places. I know you guys out in California and probably New York are paying more than that and have been. But nevertheless, you know, any excuse to stick it to us, stick it to the middle class, you know, the guys, people who are trying to get out there and work and get business done. People who need it the most, pay the most, it seems that way at least. So, you know, it's very frustrating. You know, it's good that looks like nobody was hurt or hurt seriously in this incident. But we'll see what the ramifications are. I read several sources and watched a couple of videos a while ago, and none of it talked about any effects as far as production or anything like that. So maybe that news will come out a little later, but just wanted to alert you on this for now. But it goes to a bigger thing that I've been thinking about, and that is gas prices. And it has a domino effect. It has that ripple effect on everything else. So, you know, the gas prices are staying up, right? I mean, it seems like the gas stations have gas now. I know there is, I'm still reading that there are truck driver shortages as far as getting the gas to the stations, but I haven't seen a station, at least in my area out here, that doesn't have, that's out of it. Everybody seems to have the gas. So, but they're going to keep the prices up. And I'm sure that's because of several things. That it's a holiday weekend. We're coming into summer here soon. People are out traveling more, trying to take a vacation, but it just hurts folks. I mean, you know, I can pay it, you know, I'm blessed to be able to pay that higher and but it still affects us, right? I mean, we're still trying to adjust. We're going to adjust our budget to make up for it. You know, but there are folks that are hurting, that have been hurting for a while before all this stuff started, before COVID, before all the gas issue that we had last month with the pipeline disruption. People who are just trying to make ends meet, put food on the table for the family, take care of the family. And now they're still going to pay these high prices to try to get places, try to get to work or to the doctor or wherever, school. So it already puts even that much more pressure on people. And then it has, like I said, it has that ripple effect. So we're paying more for gas. That's gonna cause everything else to go up, including your food, even from where it is now. Because, you know, the truck, anything that's gonna be delivered by a truck, any goods or services delivered by truck is going to go up now because this is going to be passed down. So if they're paying, transportation is paying more for the gasoline, who does that get passed on to? Us, you and me. So that makes everything else go up, makes the hardship that much more. So it attacks, it's like it attacks the middle class, the regular folks, the regular people, doesn't it? So it's very frustrating. It pisses me off, to tell you the truth. It really does. I don't know who to blame for sure. I mean, do you blame the president usually gets blamed for when things are really good or really bad, whether it's their fault or not. Seems like they would have some kind of influence on this. I don't know for sure. Is it taxes? Is it the oil companies? I know the supply and demand is part of it. You know, we have to think about what we can do to mitigate it. You know, maybe combine our trips more when we go out and run our errands. Adjust your budget in other places to make up for it. You know, so these are things we need to think about and prepare. And this is just what we're going to be dealing with. All right. So anyway, that's all I have at the moment. If you hear anything else on this, drop it down in the comments. I'd appreciate it. Still a holiday weekend. Like I said earlier, get out there and enjoy it. Remember what it's about tomorrow. It's about honoring the fallen heroes who made the ultimate sacrifice for your freedom, my freedom. So just remember that for sure. But also, get together when you can, or if you can with your family or friends, enjoy it. But if you go out, of course, like I said earlier, make sure you stay aware, stay vigilant, and but have fun. Don't be afraid. But anyway, take care. Be safe out there. God bless you.